Let us take the next question. I'll read what is given here. In a flat belt, initial tension is 1800 Newton. Angle of lap on smaller pulley is 170 degree. Coefficient of friction is 0.25. The diameter of pulley is 90 cm. It runs at 540 rpm. Find increase in power transmitted if the initial tension is increased by 10%. So this is the question which we have. Whatever is given here, I will write that in the form of data first. So let us start this problem. It is given in a flat belt, initial tension is 1800 Newton. So T0, that is the notation of initial tension, it is 1800 Newton. Angle of lap on the smaller pulley is 170 degree. So theta is given. I'll convert it into radian by multiplying it by pi, dividing it by 180. So that is 2.96 radians. Then coefficient of friction is 0.25. The diameter of the pulley is 90 centimeter. So I'll write down D is equal to 90 centimeter, or we can say it is 0.9 meters. Next, it runs at 540 rpm, speed is given. Question is to find the increase in power transmitted if initial tension is increased by 10%. So we have to find out increase in power. That's our question. If the initial tension is increased by 10%, it means T0 is increased by 10%. So that will be, I'll denote it by T0 dash. So it is 1.1 of T0. That is the increase of 10%. Now, let us try to get the solution for this. Since they are telling us to calculate increase in power, in this question, the initial tension which they have given first, that is 1800 Newton. By using this initial tension, I will first calculate the tension in tight side and tension in slack side, that is T1, T2 values. And by using that, we would be calculating the power. After that, we would increase this belt tension by 1.1, that is 10%. So by increasing the belt tension, we will again calculate the power, and then we will compare the two values and know how much would be the increase in power. So let us start the solution for this problem. I'll say that since the velocity of belt over the pulley is given by velocity V is equal to pi d n by 60, that's the formula. Now, therefore, it will be equal to pi d is given, it is 0.9 into n, it's 540 divided by 60. So from this, I will get the velocity of V, velocity of the belt, and that comes out to be 25.44 meter per second. So this much is the velocity of belt which is passing over the pulley. Now, since in this problem mu and theta are given, so with the help of that I will calculate the ratio of belt tension. I'll say that since belt tension ratio is given by T1 upon T2 is equal to e raised to mu theta. So it is equal to e raised to mu value in the question, it is given as 0.25. theta we have already converted it into radian, value is 2.96. So from this, I will get the relation as T1 is equal to 2.09 times of T2. I will keep this my equation as capital A. Now after using the belt tension, I will be using the initial tension which they have given. I'll say that since initial tension in the belt is given by initial tension is T0 is equal to T1 plus T2 divided by 2. Therefore, initial tension T0, it is given as 1800. Now, in place of T1, I will write it as 2.09 T2. We have got this relation from equation number A. T1 is equal to 2.09 T2, that is from equation A. Now therefore, if I calculate this, it would be 1800, this 2 would get multiplied, that becomes 3600. If I add T2, here I have 2.09 as a coefficient and here it is 1. So 2.09 plus 1 becomes 3.09. So finally 3600 divided by 3.09, I will get the value of T2 as, it is 1165.04 newton. Next, I will say that put T2 is equal to 1165.04 newton in equation A. Therefore, T1, it will be equal to 2.09 times of T2. So finally, T1 value will be 2434.95 newton. So once I have T1, T2 values, I can go on for calculating the value of power. I'll say that since power transmitted by belt drive is given by P is equal to T1 minus T2 into the velocity of belt which is passing over the pulley. Therefore, P is equal to T1 value, it was 2434.95 minus T2 is 1165.04 into the velocity which we have calculated previously. The velocity of the belt which was passing over the pulley, it was 25.44. So multiplied by 25.44, from this I will be getting the value of power, that is 32.31 into 10 raised to 3 watts, or I can say 32.31 kilowatts. I'll keep this as equation number 1. Now, in the question, they were saying that to calculate increase in power transmitted if initial tension is increased by 10%. So first we have calculated the power by using the initial tension which they have given. Now we will again calculate the power by increasing the initial tension. So I'll say that after this, since initial tension is increased by 10%, it is given. Therefore, new initial tension, I will write it as T0 dash, it is 1.1 times of T0. Therefore, T0 dash will be equal to 1.1 into 1800, and that is 1980 newton. Now I will use this initial tension and again calculate T1 and T2. So I'll say that since T0 dash is equal to, I'll write down T1 dash plus T2 dash divided by 2. So therefore, T0 dash it is 1980 is equal to, the belt tension ratio will remain same, that belt tension ratio was 2.09 times of T2 dash. So T1 dash is 2.09 T2 dash plus T2 dash divided by 2. I will say that this is from equation A, so refer equation number A. Therefore, here if I calculate, T2 dash will be 1281.55 Newton. Therefore, I will say that put T2 dash in equation number A. So therefore, in equation A, I will have T1 dash is equal to 2.09 into T2 dash is 1281.55. So therefore, T1 dash comes out to be 2678.44 Newton. After getting T1 dash, T2 dash, again I will calculate new power. I'll say that since new power, that will be equal to T1 dash minus T2 dash into velocity. So it is equal to T1 dash is 2678.44 minus T2 dash is 1281.55. It is 1281.55 into the velocity, which is 25.44. So from this I will be getting the value of new power. New power is that in which we have increased the initial tension in the belt, and the answer is 35.54 into 10 raised to 3 watts, or I can say 35.54 kilowatts. Now from this we can say that initially, I'll say this is my equation number 2. Initially the power was 32.31 kilowatts. Next, when the belt tension ratio is increased by 10%, the new power is 35.54 kilowatts. That is, there is an increase in power. So therefore I will write down percentage increase in power. It will be new power, which is 35.54, minus the power which we have got initially, and we are comparing it with the initial power, that is 32.31 into 100. So my value comes out to be 10%. It means if we are increasing the initial tension in the belt by 10%, then we are getting the increase in power also as 10%. So from this it is very much clear that when we are mounting the belt over the pulley, we need to increase the tension of that belt, because increasing that tension increases the power which is transmitted by the belt drive, and hence the efficiency of the belt drive increases. With this, we complete this question.